Good morning, YouTube. Right, well, I'm very happy. It's finally arrived. I think it's my Remington, is it all Winchester or whatever. I'll name it properly. I got this from Denick's. It came this morning, 1866 rifle, which is absolutely amazing. Do you like my CGI moustache and eyebrows? I'll give you a wave. So I got this morning. I am filming this in front of my computer. So, you know, I have to go outside. Got time to set the camera up. So I got this morning. Absolutely adore it. It's going to go on the wall. And I've had to close the curtains because I don't want the neighbours seeing it. You know, that I don't want to freak them out. They're really strict on gun laws in the UK. So once this is on the wall, it's out of the way. It's solid metal and brass. It weighs a bloody ton. When I got it this morning, it were freezing. It were freezing cold. I've had to warm it up. And I'm really happy. I've got a thing for like science fiction weapons, and this baby has appeared in a lot of science fiction films over the years, you know, Valley of the Gwangi and stuff like that. So I'm really happy with this. I'll show you the other side. Right. So here we have the trigger. So let me just do that. So you cock it, don't. So I'm just going to go around now. Whoops, I'm messing this up. So here it is. That's it there. So, right. So let me just get this sorted. Sorry, this is going to be a terrible review. So here it is. Very happy. It's very heavy, solid. So where you put the bullets, I think you can put like replicas in and the fire out at the top. I have got some bullets. I've got the Colt pistol, the Peacemaker. I got this from Denick's. So as you can see, so I'll just press the trigger. But very happy. I don't think I'll be going to any conventions, but this dressed up as Clint Eastwood or the High Chaparral. So, yeah. So I'm just going along. I have a selection of sci-fi weapons from Captain Cold's Ice Gun to Star Trek Phasers, and I still haven't got them all on the wall. I've got a massive box full of them. So as you can see, I'm just going across now. I'm doing this, you know, in front of my webcam, so forgive me on this. So I'm just going along. So let's go to that there, where the ejector. So, right, hang on. And then the bullet obviously comes out, so you put in here. Turn it around. Well, there was a shop in Leeds called Fantasia. When I was last in Leeds before one of the many lockdowns we've had, I was going to buy one, but it was getting it back to where I lived, and I didn't really want to be dragging this around, you know, in a suitcase and that. So I thought I'd wait. So I went back to Fantasia, but they didn't have any left. They sold them all. So I did some digging, found Denick's UK, and I bought this. I bought it on Friday, and it came today. So, oh, yeah, I thought I'd go Western with the moustache. So the moustache is CGI with the eyebrows, as you can tell. So I don't know. So I watched an episode of The High Chaparral this morning on YouTube. You know, oh, I love that. I mean, that is, you know, that is so bloody cool. You know, it does have a targeting scope. Yeah, that's actually plastic, and it's a bit shitty, is that actually? So, like, you can look down there. Let me just see if I can give you a full view. But as you can see, that's the targeting thing there, and you have a little thing to sort of work out where you're going to target stuff. So I'm just going to shut that down. But it's very heavy. It is incredibly heavy. But I know you can buy airsoft stuff. And I bought quite a bit from Wolf Armouries over the years. But apparently replica weapons, it's a bit weird in the UK. Apparently they were telling me on the phone, because I wanted to buy a Garand rifle. And they wouldn't sell me one. And I wanted the grease gun as well, you know. And they said, no, they're only for enactment groups and that. But I can buy anything, I think, from 1866. So I've always wanted one of these. And it goes with a pistol as well. So I thought, yeah, that'll make a nice selection. I'm not buying a holster, you know, becoming an El Bandido. But it's a beautiful piece, very happy. And they're not that expensive. So I thought, because it's locked down, I'm going to treat myself. You know, I'm not going out much now. And so I just thought I'd focus on my collecting and get the house done. So I'm really happy with this. It's absolutely amazing. So this is my review of the Denix. I think it is. Hang on. I'm going to find out what this is. Is it the Winchester or the... hang on, let me just find out. Yeah, Denix Winchester rifle, solid brass trim, 1866. I just didn't want to get it wrong, that's all. So, here we go. So that's it. So this is my review of that. I'm sorry I filmed it in front of a webcam, but, you know. There you go. Well, I like to get 3 videos up a week, and so I thought I'd get this one up today. I'm honestly really ecstatic when this comes. Really well. You know, so I was going to put the High Chaparral music in the background and then start posing. But yeah, very happy with this. So, guys, I will see you on the next video. Stay safe, and I'm gonna admire this for a bit, I think. So I'll see you on the next video. Okay, guys, there is another episode of Could Have Been a Classic. I'm just doing that now. You're not going to believe what I'm doing that on. Hang on, just one more time. Oh, wow. I just feel like John Wayne, you know, the Duke. I'm only joking. All right, guys, stay safe, and I'll see you on the next video.